I've deliberately waited to release this video rather than jumping on the algorithm-driven controversy train. I'm not interested in appearing as a one-trick pony, and I'm certainly not here to stoke distro wars. However, some clarification is needed. Let me be clear from the start. I'm not angry at Ubuntu Studio. If you watched my recent review, that should be obvious. I still think it's a brilliant all-in-one package. But I'm disappointed with a particular decision Ubuntu made. And to explain why, let me tell you a story. Years ago, there was a chap who looked remarkably like me, though with more hair and less gray in his beard. This chap ran a small plumbing and heating company with a partner. In their operating area, heating system supplier A was outstanding. Excellent technical support, readily available parts, and they worked well with small installers like us. Supplier B, however, dominated the national and international market. They supplied everything from small schools to hospitals and laboratories. But they treated small installers rather like the stepchild in a fairy tale. Orders would be cancelled without explanation, presumably to reroute them to larger customers. Now, we didn't really enjoy working with Company B, but many medium-sized buildings, four-story condominiums, small office blocks, that kind, they used their system, and for good reason. Top-tier performance and longevity. Company A's systems worked perfectly well and used off-the-shelf parts, making repairs straightforward. Company B's system were entirely proprietary. Special sensors, switches, the lot. But this proprietary approach meant they could guarantee their systems wouldn't become obsolete due to changing building codes or green energy requirements. Customers were willing to pay for that security, which meant we were stuck maintaining those legacy installations. Most customers, they were happy to switch to Company A when replacement became inevitable. At that point, Company B's pricing bore little to no relation to actual longevity, particularly compared to Company A's newer offerings. And there was another consideration. If repairs were needed when we weren't available, any local plumber could service Company A's system. Company B wouldn't even connect a private customer to their support without a partner identification login. But here's the thing, regardless of how much we disagreed with Company B's practices, we would never actively sabotage a customer's heating system. We wouldn't remove a proprietary sensor to render it inoperable or accelerate its obsolescence in any way. And that brings us to Ubuntu. Let me show you the Nvidia driver in question. Here is the version for old Quadro cards. And over here is the version for old GeForce cards. You'll notice it's the same driver. And a new version was released on June 4th, 2024. Roughly 2 months after Ubuntu 24.04 LTS launched. Now, pay attention. I'm not saying Ubuntu Studio specifically. This decision potentially affected every official Ubuntu flavor. Kubuntu, Ubuntu Studio, the lot. The ones that follow Ubuntu's update schedule. At some point in the, third quarter of 2025, if I remember correctly, Ubuntu removed the low latency kernel dependency needed for the proprietary Nvidia driver and replaced it with a newer one. So let's examine the Nouveau driver that was meant to replace it. First, Credit where credit is due. I said that in my other video. The fact that the development team got these old cards working at all is just shy of black magic to me. Looking at the news page, August 2024, NVK enabled for Blackwell and Kepler GPUs, starting with Mesa 25.2. The article itself explains, starting with Mesa 25.2, NVK will now advertise support for Blackwell and Kepler GPUs. On Blackwell, NVK supports Vulkan 1.4, while Kepler is limited to Vulkan 1.2 due to hardware limitations, which is perfectly fine. Still, this raises a serious question in my opinion. Wouldn't it be possible to leave the dependency in place, or at a minimum provide a warning like, we are replacing this dependency, which might render your proprietary driver unusable? Would you like to proceed or postpone this update? Or just maybe have a rollback function in place? That would be another option. And then there's this situation. For demonstration purposes, I've equipped my trusty Optiplex with an Nvidia Quattro K2200, running Ubuntu Studio 24.04.3 from my previous video. And I apologize for the image quality. I rather foolishly filmed the screen instead of recording it. Yeah. Here's the Ubuntu driver manager, correctly identifying the driver and noting that an alternate driver is currently in use. So for anyone experiencing glitches with Nouveau, switching to the Nvidia driver would seem obvious, wouldn't it? But nope. You're no longer allowed to. Once again, a rollback function or at least a dialog box explaining the required changes would be a sensible approach. Just remember Ubuntu's target audience, particularly for official flavors like EduBuntu and Ubuntu Studio. These aren't usually the people whose daily work centers on terminal commands and development. Considering the caveats in the Nouveau article, wouldn't it be prudent to wait until the quirks are sorted? Like an early push on what Ubuntu calls the number one open source operating system powering millions of PCs and laptops, that results in disgruntled users and bug reports, doesn't that put unnecessary pressure on the driver team? Why not maintain the current driver until Nouveau is genuinely ready? You know, I'm not advocating for proprietary drivers. If there's a legitimate alternative and you can stick it to the man, well, excellent, go for it. But shouldn't, generally speaking, the currently best working solution be the one in deployment? Also, I think questionable behavior shouldn't be apologizable simply because it comes from your own team. Consider this. If Microsoft killed legacy hardware support, everyone would be up in arms. Yeah, that's precisely what they did with Windows 11, amongst other things. And it's one of the reasons why we are seeing a spike in Linux desktop adoption. And rightfully so. Like, Ubuntu doesn't do the Linux ecosystem any favors by behaving in a similar way, and it shouldn't be acceptable either. Like them or not, Ubuntu is largely the poster child of mainstream Linux. If they are positioning themselves as the main competitor to Windows in the desktop space, and please let's save that discussion for another time, then it's in everyone's interest that they make switching to Linux as smooth as possible, not alienate people by removing hardware support that's not only available, but was recommended at the LTS launch. So, I don't know, maybe keep the support for existing proprietary software in place until the open source alternative is nearly 100% ready for deployment. The argument that you should know ahead of time that Nvidia and Linux don't mix, or you need to know Linux to use Linux, it's a little bit rubbish, guys. Many people use computers because they have to, not because they enjoy it. They have neither interest nor time for a deep dive. And judging by Ubuntu's positioning, that's precisely who they should have in mind. So, you made it to the end of the video, which now qualifies you to go into the comment section and tell me how wrong I am. But keep in mind, the majority of computer users won't install Arch, which had apparently its own issues recently, and that's perfectly fine, but the majority of discrete graphic cards in deployment are Nvidia GPUs. That's simply a fact, whether you like it or not.